children of all ages. Welcome back to another exciting weekend vlog with your host, Kennedy Lucas. Okay, so we're here at K.L.P. Entertainment Host Stream Studios, where in film, we trust. Yes, that is our new slogan. If you've seen it all over Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, the websites, everywhere. It's been everywhere since of yesterday. Of course, in film, we trust is our new slogan for K.L.P. Entertainment's business. Of course, Host Dream Studios has the same slogan. K.L.P. Photography has the same slogan. And I'm just really, really happy that we finally picked a slogan word for our label, because when you have a slogan, it's very important because it shows who you are. If you think about McDonald's, let's say McDonald's, I'm loving it. That's their slogan. Or Subway, Eat Fresh. That's their slogan, you know. Having a company slogan is really good. And now, K.L.P. Entertainment finally has a slogan of In Film We Trust. Hopefully you guys love those words. I'm going to be using that a lot as of late. I'm going to be using it a lot. So stay tuned for that, because, you know, every advertisement, every publication, everything, we're going to have something to fit In Film We Trust, because we do trust our film, we do trust our work, we trust what we do here for K.L.P. Entertainment to produce great shows like that for you guys. So just really, really happy that you guys love it. I have my handy dandy iPhone SE. I recently got a new case. This is an OtterBox case, all black, so it really works. Just to show you guys there, it's nice and bulky, like a businessman phone, so I love it. It's durable. I've dropped this a couple times, and the testing is really good on this thing. Sort of expensive, so if you want to get good quality, go to, and I got this from, I think I had this from the AT&T store. My service is Sprint. I went to Sprint. They didn't have a case for this phone, so I ended up going to AT&T and seeing that they had an OtterBox in hand in stock, and this was my color, so I love it. So the point of it, I have my phone with notes. Of course, I don't never like to go without notes, because I tend to forget what I'm going to talk about on today's show. And then when I forget, I'm going to editing. We go into the editing room. We're editing the footage. And then I say, oh, snap, I forgot to say something. So next thing on the list of stuff to talk about, of course, the website has been sort of updated with a little bit of bug fixing. We fixed the bugs out of our website, so that's fully updated. We're not going to update it to like the new top threes until next week, because we still have to review more stuff. So K.L.P. fans, you know, stay tuned for that. The update's coming really soon with all new anime and all new movies and all new games to be reviewed, of course, alongside the blogging site. We're going to update the blogging site next week, so please stay tuned for that as well, because that's going to be happening really, really soon. Of course, we're going to talk a little bit about anime. Of course, I've been back to my anime game. Finally, it's been a while since I talked about anime. It's been a while since I've been on the show of Weekend Vlog, because we've been so busy perfecting everything else. I got some news announcements, but we'll wait until later at the end of the show. Of course, anime has been reviewed again this weekend. We watched it, and we just really analyzed it really well. We got two new animes. Of course, Show by Rock Season 2 was over, and Kiss Me Not Him, we ended their season as well with the final episodes. So, we're on to new anime. I'm really happy. It's kind of sad to see that an anime is over, because that's it. And it makes you sad, but it makes you happy, because there's another new anime out there that you want to go see, and we're going to review it really, really new. So, of course, God Eater is one of the shows that we picked up. A lot of anime fans had told me just go see or go watch God Eater, and it's been a while since I saw that notification, like, hey, check out God Eater. It's been years, and it's been on the list. It hasn't been that long, but it's been about maybe a year and a half, because we've been picked up other anime shows out there. God Eater is a good show. I really do love this animation style. We're really considering that to be our number one. I normally don't say that in the show, but the anime structure, how the way the graphic style is really, really awesome. So I really do love that show for what it is. The anime style is really good. God Eater is mostly seen in, of course, in the anime series, but they have characters from the show into the game that I truly love. Again, if anybody asks me what's my favorite RPG, I say Project Cross Zone or Project Cross Zone 2 or Project X Zone, however you want to say it. They have two games. I want to collect the first one. I got the second one, but I want the first one. Nowadays at GameStop, they're really hard to find because everybody has bought them out, so it's just like it's hard to find another copy of that. But God Eater, they picked some of the characters from the show and it's in the game, so I sort of know them from the game that I have, Project Cross Zone 2. And I really Googled to show up, and it turns out they actually had an anime series, and we finally picked it up for review. So I can't wait to see it. We just started episode one, so we're gonna we'll review more of that more, and you guys will see more of that with podcasts, blogging sites, and hopefully maybe win the top three picks for the anime. We still got a review. And another show we started reviewing is Tamako Market. Of course, it's about this girl who is, you know, has a brother and sister, and, no, a sister and a father, and you know, she goes to this market and she's picking flowers, and then she picks up a flower, and there's a bird on the flower. It turns out the bird can talk, and as the story progresses, the bird started to jag a little bit of memory and actually understands where he's coming from, and he gets fat because he eats a lot of bread. So that's just that show's really good as well. The anime style, it kind of looks like K-On! If you guys remember, we reviewed K-On! And K-On! Season 2 and K-On! The movie as well. So that's kind of the anime art style. It just kind of reminds me of K-On! So I cannot wait until we review those two shows, because those two shows are going to be really great for our reviewings, podcasting, blogging sites, and it's going to be phenomenal. Now we're going to take a quick commercial break, but we do have a lot more to talk about. Stay tuned. Fans, welcome back to the show. We can vlog here at K.L.P. Entertainment, where we, in film, we trust. I love the slogan. So there's this new show that I've just now started watching. Of course, it's not anime. This is a normal show from Stars Originals. Of course, this show is really awesome. Of course, it kind of it doesn't remind me of Power, but Power and this show here, they're from Stars. They both are in the Stars company, so that's gonna be really good. So take a look of this trailer of this show.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cab Calloway.
I just wanna thank my family. I love you.
He's kind of blubber like a little bitch.
Can I get some money for lunch?
Shut up and give me some money.
I'm taking an extra 100.
Sure, man. Ask me where my dick is in my hand and my wallet's in yours. Ain't that what I did?
I'm feeling real good, cause today is a good day.
Hey, you in the East now, baby. I gotta tell you up.
This is the oldest black-owned country club in America.
How long has it been around?
11 years.
We fell from the Titanic and landed in a lifeboat. I feel guilty. I'm surviving and there's people drowning.
Some tweaker does not deserve a spot on your generosity list just because he grew up two doors down.
Schindler had his list.
Really? The Titanic? Schindler's? What did you spend the day watching a bunch of depressing movies? Let's watch Amistad next.
I'm feeling real good cause today is a good day.
Yes, Survivor's Remorse is a great show. We've been through season one, season two, and we're now on season three with this show. I've been binge watching this show while eating snacks or during homework. I've been watching this show. Of course, really, really good show. Just is phenomenal. You have to watch it just to believe it. Of course, it's really good. Of course, it's the main character, his name is Cam. Cameron. I forgot their last name, but Cameron, he's a famous basketball player for Atlanta. And of course, they moved his family from Boston to Atlanta, and he's playing ball, he's getting all this money. But then there's a little bit of controversy, drama, a lot of stuff that goes on to this show. Of course, he has his agent named Reggie. Reggie is played by this actor that I know him from Madea Goes to Jail. I think that's where his movie, that's when I first know of that actor. Of course, he played multiple other stuff, but that's the movie I know him from. Of course, Tasha, if it's Tasha or Tisha Arnold, is also in the show. Phenomenal actress. You know, she's done plenty of work. Her funniest work, I'd say Everybody Hates Chris in Wild Hogs. She played also in that movie as well. The sister, Her name is Mary Charles. Charles is the last name. Sorry, I just remembered. Mary Charles. The Charles is the last name. Mary Charles is the sister. Of course, she is in the LGBT community. So, you know, you really get to see her express herself in the show. Mike Epps is in the show. Spoiler alert for you guys out there. Of course, they kill him off in the show. That's all I'm going to say. But Mike Epps is in the show. He's playing the uncle. Uncle Julius, he's funny. He's really funny in this show. He brings a bit of seriousness, but with a little bit of comedic theme into the show as well. So the show is just phenomenal. Of course, Romeo Miller makes a special appearance in the show every now and then. The actor from Pitch is also in the show. The guy who is also the baseball player plays in this show as well. Let's see. And there's many, many other actors and actresses that are in the show that I cannot think of. But please, go see Survivor's Remorse, Lucas and Extra Man's, because you would not be disappointed. Because this show is just phenomenal. I love this show. It's really, really funny. Of course, we're going to talk about some other good things here. Of course, this goes on to our collaborations division for K.L.P. Entertainment and HostStream Studios. Tonight, K.L.P. Entertainment and HostStream Studios will be filming a special video for my brother. Of course, he's hosting a event here on campus, and I'm going in to film it. The purpose why I'm telling you guys this is because this weekend, hopefully, by the time you see it, you'll know. This weekend, we're going to have the video out. We're calling it Into the Mixture Montage. Of course, it's an event that is sponsored by my brother. He's also in this other organization. He is talking, he's not talking. It's kind of like a party, but it's like a meet and greet party. Of course, there's people that you could be straight, you could be gay, you could be lesbian, you can be whatever you want to be and come to this party or event and meet and greet other people that are just like you. I think it's a really good event. Hence that today is Valentine's Day, so by the time you're saying it, it's going to be the weekend. But if you had a great Valentine's Day, then I'm glad that you had a good Valentine's Day. But now that it's the weekend, it's probably all over. So that's coming up really soon. If not, you probably can see it on the channel right now. Into the Mixture montage is coming up really soon. I hope to do really, really good film work for that, for the event and for the video. And hopefully HostStream Studios can really get it done right. And not hopefully, I know they will. That's my company, my second company of that. Let's see. We're going to let's talk about this one more thing before we go on commercial break. I'm sorry, Lucas Nation fans. Of course, Insprion Gaming is now available for twitch.tv/InsprionGaming. That is our gaming channel. So check us out. We do some really good gaming channels. Of course, Lucas Chat Podcast is a proud sponsor for Insprion Gaming. So mostly a podcast of video games will be going on to Insprion Gaming as well. So check us out for Twitch. If you love gaming, you love all that stuff, go to twitch.tv/InsprionGaming to see our great gameplay. We're going to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we have a little bit more to talk about. Stay tuned. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Welcome back to the Weekend Show, Weekend Vlog Show here with your host, Kimberly Lucas, where we, in film, we trust. I'm telling you guys, that slogan's going to be going, I'm going to be saying that a minute because I just love that slogan. Of course, we have a bit of some news announcements. Of course, news on Sonic Mania is coming up really, really soon, y'all. I've read on the internet, and sometimes I don't trust the internet so much, but Sega will be releasing information about Sonic Mania and the new Sonic game that's coming out this year on March 3rd, around 8 p.m.-ish. They don't know if they're going to be streaming that kind of information out there, but that information is coming, and holy crap, I cannot wait for that information because I'm a huge Sonic fan. I've been playing Sonic since I was born. And they haven't been, I'll be honest, they haven't been on the great slopes lately with their game sales of 2016-15. 2011, they were great. 2012, they were okay. 13, 14, 15, it's like, okay. So 2017, this year, is a brand new Sonic game that's coming out. And I'm probably going to pre-order. If I like what I'm hearing and I'm liking the news, I probably will pre-order this game because this game will be out for the newest console that's coming out March 3rd, Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4. Of course, I will be getting my copy for Xbox One because why not? You know, I have one. I might as well build my collection up. So it's going to be really, really awesome. So stay tuned for K.L.P. Entertainment and bloggings and host stream studios because we're going to have more information about that coming really, really soon. So stay tuned. Speaking of Xbox, of course, we have two games that I wanted to quick formal review for you guys out there. I did say in my last weekend vlog that I will be building up some more games for you guys. Play them, tell you how I really feel about these games. And, you know, I told you guys this last week, and it's been a while since we've done something like this. So I've got two games here. I was able to get a sort of a bonus from work. So I didn't splurge a lot, but I did end up getting some things I wanted. Really, really happy about it because I'm a gamer. Lately, I haven't been playing games because I'm either in class, I'm either doing K.L.P. entertainment work, or I'm at production with my other job. So it's just so much that I got going, but it's okay. I love to stay busy, but sometimes I wish that I had more time to film and do things for you guys for YouTube, and now it's a special moment. Of course, the first game I wanted to sort of talk to you guys about that I truly love. A lot of people didn't like, but I like this one. I am newly an Xbox player, owner. I've had an Xbox 360 with my brother. We shared it a long time ago. I ended up, you know, buying my own consoles, and now I am back. I am back with an Xbox One. Of course, next gen, I did say to myself, I'm going to get a next gen console this year. Like, that's the goal. So I ended up dead, and you guys, please check out my big, huge unboxing video for the Xbox One. It's really good. So this game here, I actually did enjoy. I dabbled into this game a little bit, and I probably might dabble more this weekend depending on my schedule. This is Halo 5 Guardians. So this is an Xbox One exclusive. I wasn't a huge Halo player. Even though we had a 360, we never really bought Halo. I never really got into it. I saw this game, and I know it was a first-person shooter, so I thought to myself, hey, I'll pick this up. I'll try it. It was a great price. It was pre-owned, so, of course, pre-owned games, they have the best price. So, why not? So, I picked this up, and I actually do enjoy this game. This is really fun. A lot of people think it ain't. A lot of people don't have mixed opinions about this game. I think it's really good. You're going between Master Chief and his crew and newer crew that's for 2016-17 standards. This game, even though it was pre-owned, it was in the paper, so that was a real good steal for me. Of course, you can play up to 24 players online. This is only one person. This is first player if you are Xbox player, so you can't really co-op with this game. The story makes sense. They say the story mode is long, which I don't really have a problem with. I like a long story mode because it gives me something to do. I typically never like games that have a story mode that's just super short because I get, you know, I beat it, you know, it's in my collection, it's getting dusty, it's like, will I pick this up? I already know what's going to happen. But with this game, it's longer story mode, and I enjoy that. Voice acting's really good. The art style's really good. Quality was fantastic. For what it is, it's very fantastic. Of course, Microsoft Studios, they're really good at their games. Let's be honest. They made some good games out there. 343 Industries, or 343 Industries, however you want to pronounce their company, helped develop this game, and this is really, really good. I'm not gonna lie, I died a couple times into this game, you know, newbie Halo player out there, so really, really good. It says an intense new story, of course. Let's see here. Exploring and conquer three worlds of Master Chief, Spartan Locke, and Solo, or four-player co-op, and that four-player co-op is only for Xbox Live, so if you play with somebody online, you can play that way, but local multiplayer, you can't, that, you know, it won't happen. Of course, an unstoppable force threatens the galaxy unless Master Chief can find out. An epic story and innovative new multiplayer modes mark the greatest evolution of Halo history. The hunt for the truth begins. This, and the cover just looks really good. I really do like this cover. So, guys, Halo 5 Guardians. So this next game here, I want to give a shout out to a lot of gamers, because a lot of people said, if you have not got this game in your collection, go get it. Of course, they did advertise this as market value, meaning that they had marketed this up really well. And of course, they let this game be released out for free for a time period, so you could have got the game for free for only maybe like a month or 2 month free trial period to get the game free. Of course, I have the first one. Of course, the first one is good. Let's see. So, I have the first one of this for PlayStation 3. And the logo looks the same, but different styles. And I'm really glad that I have both of these. So, you've guys seen this one. You've guys seen Watch Dogs. You know, this ain't the game. But I've showed this in my collection. It's been a while since I played this game, really. It's been a while since I played this game. But this was great. But, there's a but for this one. This one is better. This is Watch Dogs 2, y'all. Okay. You guys like how I hit that there. So, Watch Dogs 2, this one is better than the first one. Hands down. I just think it's better. The only thing, so the story is set in San Francisco, beautifully designed into this game. You're in San Francisco and you're hacking, yes, yet again. You're playing all new characters. You're not playing the same character from this one. You're playing a different character in this one. So, of course you're hacking. There's a story mode you're hacking to get money, to get weapons, to get all sorts of stuff you want to get into this game. You can hack traffic lights, kind of almost like the first one, but a little bit different. You have a little bit more of a character spread out, so there's more characters into this game. A lot of YouTubers have reviewed this game, and I agree with them. The driving mechanics of this game is kind of lagging just a little bit. That's okay, it's not a huge problem for me, but the driving mechanics of this game is like, okay, it's a little loose. You're hacking everything into this game. And that's not just saying it just because it says it on the cover of the case, but you're literally hacking everything. It's very intense, really, really good game. The weapon style is good, and it makes sense for this year's standards. So please explore an open world of San Francisco Bay Area, so where the bridge is up to that city, and it's just, that's all I can say about this game. Pick this one up, y'all. If you have not picked this, any Watch Dogs game up, pick this one up, because you would not be disappointed into this one. So, as mentioned before, the podcast will be coming back really, really soon with all new podcasts of anime and shows. Of course, podcasting over these two games, so stay tuned for that, because we're going to do gameplay for Insprion Gaming over at Twitch, and we're also going to be doing some podcasting. Me and Tyra is going to go in on both these games coming up really soon, so stay tuned for both of those podcast shows. Lucas Chat Podcast, you know, we're great at that. I love it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed today's show. We're here at K.L.P. Entertainment, and film we trust. I'm Kennedy Lucas, logging out.